Welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time tuning in, you are most welcome. Kindly subscribe and hit that bell so that you can be notified whenever I upload new video. Thank you, my new viewers, and to my new subscriber. I really appreciate you for tuning in. And those that care to watch my video, I say thumbs up to you, because when I look at my channel, even if it's 1, 10, 20, I am so glad that somebody is able to take up that time to listen to what I'm saying. And thank you for that. I really appreciate that. You guys keep me going on with my channel, with my topic. And so it encourages me every other time to like, oh, my viewers are out there. I need to put something out there for them. So today I'm just going to talk about different things that are in my mind right now about this situation. It's not about the coronavirus, but just something about life. So I want to say thank you once more for watching. I really appreciate all of you, all of the time that you spend watching my channel. But don't forget, let us keep safe, secure ourselves, protect ourselves, our family, and follow the rules and regulations of this coronavirus. Thank you guys, keep tuned. Don't forget, hit that bell and watch my video to the end, because the beginning is not the end. I have more and more things that I talk about that go through the end. So watch it from the beginning all the way to the end. Today, I want to talk about us ladies. And yeah, you know, this time that we are in, our husbands are home, the kids are home, the family are home. Even the husbands that used to go out there, that stay out there and don't want to come home, some of them put it on work, some of them go to girlfriends. They are home now. This is one of the advantage of quarantine, you know. We love that, you know, ladies. I know that. Yeah, they are home. And the kids are home. We are having a beautiful family time. Trust me, I know that. Anyway, guys, while we are home, to you ladies that don't know how to prepare food, because I know it's not everybody that know how to prepare food. I tell you, my dear, when I was a little girl coming up, I was not in the kitchen with my mom. No way. I love the street. I like to play. I was always out there with my friend playing. We're going to dance culture. We're going to visit this other friend. We're going here and there. It's my sister that used to be in the kitchen with our mom. So I really never used to be in the kitchen with my mom. So when I started growing up, and then when I cook, yeah, when I started to stay with my dad, when I cook, he can say, she cooked some again. And then he will wait for my sister to come and cook good food for him to eat. But hey, I was going to get married someday, have my family settled down, so I had to learn how to cook. Even though I did not learn it when I was a little girl growing up, but I had to learn it when I started living on my own. I started to cook every other day. Sometimes when I cook some food, my cousin would say, oh, you prepare this. I say, yeah. I say, oh, nice, you're doing well. And I started learning how to cook step by step, step by step. And I can cook. I can cook. To the extent that when I used to sell food, if I sell food, oh, people really used to love and enjoy my food. Like, I remember the other day, one of my girlfriend and her husband was coming over for a weekend, and she was like, girl, can you cook? You know how to cook now? I said, come on, shut up. Because she left and came on the side a long time ago. We were still growing up, still staying with our parents. I said, my dear, when you left, I learned how to cook, so I know how to cook. So you see, it's not everybody that know how to cook. So we have to learn it gradually. What about some ladies that spend most of their high school time on a mission? Some of them don't know how to cook. What about some that have cooks to their house? Some stay in the kitchen with the cooks and learn how to cook. And some of us, we are big now, and yet and still we don't know how to cook. And so I tell you today, my ladies, this time that we have, let us use it to the best of our ability. You know, every disappointment is a blessing. Let us take everything that is happening right now. Let us adjust ourselves to it right now. When it passes, we can go back to our normal life. Yeah, our normal lives. But let's adjust ourselves to it and go along with it. But keep ourselves safe, keep ourselves protected, our family, our loved ones secure, and adjust to this situation because we don't know when it's going to end, but we know that it will end and it's going to pass over us. So I tell you today, my lady, go in the kitchen, look for a cookbook, or go on YouTube. There are a lot of food. There are the kids here. Most of them, they don't eat the food. For we Africans, most of them, they don't eat the food. They eat this small stuff, and sometimes the small stuff are not there to get. For them, some of them like the fries, this, that. Sometimes you're not going out there every day to buy for them. Or you're coming from where you stop into this place to buy for the kids. Or you take the kids along, you stop and buy for them. Try to learn how to make those fries on your own. Try to learn how to make the kids' food, the things that the kids love to eat, to make it on your own. Try and do that. Let us try to learn how to cook so that we can stop ordering. Now we don't order food. We don't order food all the time. We don't order food most of the time. So we have to learn how to do this. We have to learn. Because if you say you're going to order food, now we are not working. Most of us are not working. It's very hard. It's very, very expensive. So we have to manage with what we have, make use of what we have, and make use of this time that we have. I'm not saying we can go out to eat, but this time we're not going out to eat. Most of us, some of us, if you're going out to eat, good for you. Sometimes we get lunch here and there, but good for you. But take this time, learn how to cook. If you don't know how to cook, keep trying it small, bit by bit, gradually, and you're going to learn it. If you come from work, now this time when we come from work, we go nowhere. We come and sit down home. For me, I'm a kind of lady that like to move about. Yeah, I move about a lot of time because my business I do after work, I have to be out there either mailing stuff to customer or delivering to customer, or I'm like trying to buy things for my business. That's what I do, and I don't do them this time. That little fear, it gets in me sometimes. Sometimes when I look outside, I'm like, I'm not seeing no movement, no normal movement. And then I'm like, when I go into work, I'm like, only my car leaving the parking lot, or you only see one more cars out of the parking lot. I'm like, what? So it's hard. It's hard. It's not normal, but we have to go along with this situation. We can't put our life on hold. We can't sit down and fold our arms and say, okay, I'm going to sit here till everything pass. No, life have to go on. And so the things that we used to do that we don't do, fine. Once we have life, we can do those things that we used to do that we are not doing right now. Once you have life, there is hope, because we know that one day all of this is going to pass, and it will definitely pass, and we'll all tell that story. So, my ladies, if you are there, if you're somebody who love to move about, don't just move about for nothing. That wife that is there to support our man. We don't marry our man for just for the man to do for us, for us to stand by that man, for us to support that man, for us to encourage that man, for us to love that man, for us to take care of the home, for us to be the wife, for us to be the mother, for us to be the person that will bring up the family. We women, don't you know that we have more knowledge, more ideas than the men? God gave us so much ability that we can do a lot of things at the same time. So let us not forget to put all of this into action and not just sit there, but to keep doing our best and set our mind. Sometimes fear holds us back in some of the things that our mind, our heart tells us to do. Sometimes other people discourage us. But when we know that yes, indeed, we want to do this, and when you focus, you set your mind from the beginning, it won't seem right. It will not be easy. But keep trying, keep pushing forward. And one day, we're going to get there and be the kind of person that we want to be. Let us love and care for one another. And stop castigating, stop the jealousy, stop the confusion. We ladies, we're supposed to hold hands in hands and work together and build up our home, build up our family, and build up our relationship. So I say to you guys, this is all I have for you today. Please don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell. And keep watching, keep tuning in. This is all my own opinion, just things that comes on my mind that I decided to talk about today, so that if you care to listen, you can listen to it, you can add up to what I'm saying, you can like pick from what I'm said today and use it for your own ability. And it's just my own opinion. Thank you for watching, guys. Have a good day. Be safe. God bless you. Bye-bye.